this right here is the Lumix 25mm f1.7. It's only 150 bucks. I've had this lens for over a year now, and I think it's finally time to give it a review. I've used it extensively, and I think it's a great lens for the price. So, let's get into it. So, just to start off, the picture quality of this lens. This lens has a very good picture quality. I've shot many, many different photos with it, and I'll show you some of those later. I do want to note that this is a prime lens, meaning that it is a fixed focal length of 25mm. If you've ever used a prime lens before, this won't really be an issue, but if you're new to prime lenses, it's something to get used to. It does force you to move around your subject a little bit, which gives you a very interesting experience when using the lens. Another thing to note is that this lens has a minimum aperture of f1.7, meaning that the ring gets to open up all the way inside of the lens to allow all the light in. This gives you a very nice bokeh effect, or depth of field, when you set it to f1.7. One drawback of this lens is that it is not image stabilized. That means that if your camera body does not have image stabilization, your photos might come out a little bit blurry, or your videos might come out a little bit shaky. Speaking of videos, this lens takes great videos, especially with the bokeh effect. It's not too good for vlogging, as like I said before, it is a 25, so for you to actually vlog with it, you would have to hold it out very far like that. So right now, I am on a 14mm focal length, and now I am on the 25mm lens. As you can see, it is a little bit more zoomed in than this other lens I was using, but it gives this great depth of field in the background, as you can see, and as I move closer to the lens, that depth of field increases. It does have a very good minimum focal length. For example, I'm about a foot away from the lens right now, and it is still focusing on me very well. The basic fit and finish of this lens is very good for the price. It has an all-plastic construction with a removable lens hood. It also comes with a little plastic ring that goes here when you're not using the lens hood. It does have silver contact plate, as you can see there, and the regular array of pins. On the front, it does come with a matte black lens cap, but I just put on my other lens cap here. Speaking of the lens itself, this is a very high quality lens, as you'll see later. Has very good glass quality in this. So enough with video and build quality, let's just see some pictures out of this. So I've used this lens in a ton of locations in the past year, and I've captured some amazing scenery with it. I'm just gonna roll some images now, and you can take a look at those. If you wanna see more of these, you can look in the comments, and you can see my Shutterstock profile, and I'll also link my Instagram as well. If you also wanna see some stock video with this lens, I'll link that in the description as well. I also thought it would be important to show you guys some 6K video out of this lens. So here's an uncompressed 6K shot at its native 4x3 resolution. And now here is a 6K clip shot at 4x3, cropped down to 16x9. In both of these clips, this lens performed amazing, and it just goes to show that this lens performs amazing when you're shooting 6K video. As you can see, images from this lens come out amazing, with the added benefit that the 25mm focal length forces you to get into different positions that might give you more creative power. And so now I've created a little bit of a cinematic sequence to show you what this lens can do with video. So, enjoy.
Yeah. So now, as you have seen, this little lens takes amazing photos and videos. So now the question is, do I recommend it? And the answer to that is yes. This lens has amazing video and picture quality at the price point. And because it's a prime lens, it'll make you move to your subject and make you think outside the box, which makes you a better photographer. If you guys have enjoyed, make sure to subscribe so I can keep doing content like this. I'll also drop a like and share it with anyone who you think would be interested. Thank you guys, and I'll see you next time.